The one thing you've been mentioning a lot are hormones. Now, as a guy, because I'm still learning about health, is that usually when you say hormones, you think it's a female related thing, but I'm starting to realize it's a male thing. And can you give us a little more insight about that?
Yeah. So, men, you want to optimize your testosterone to your estrogen ratio, your testosterone to your dehydrotestosterone ratio, and look at free and total testosterone levels in your blood. Get it tested, non-fasting, you know, abstain from exercise for 24 hours and get it done before 10 a.m. because testosterone is higher in the morning. And if it's low or low normal in the range, the total testosterone range is pretty broad. It's gone down, which is a whole other conversation we can touch on in a second. But essentially, you want to be at like the 80 to 100th percentile, like the last 20% of that normal range or higher. And if you're not, if you're less than half, then something's going on and you need to figure out why that's happening and work with someone like me or my colleagues that know how to look at these things. And most people don't know how to look at male hormones because, like you said, it's like, oh, you're in normal range. You're good, dude. You're not even 50. Andropause is like male menopause. And this doesn't happen until you're 49 or 50 plus, which is partially true because naturally your testosterone is going to decrease total testosterone 1% every year after age 30 and free testosterone about 2%. However, most guys that I'm talking to now under age 35, 20 to 35, and even younger have very low testosterone. You know, I'm talking like less than 400, and after 400 total testosterone.
That's me.
Yeah.
That's me.
Yeah.
It's stress.
It's stress. It's not sleeping enough because, like, you know, if you're an entrepreneur, like we are, sleep is like the first thing to go. You know, your ability to nurture yourself and say, hey, you know, I need to take 3 hours off today. I need to go to the gym for an hour, hour and a half. I need to meditate for half an hour and I need to run an errand and go buy some healthy food and cook it up. And then I need to go to bed before 11 o'clock or 10 o'clock. If you're an early morning person and get at least 7.5 hours of sleep or 7 hours of sleep. So you're making enough testosterone in that hour and a half of REM sleep. That's when you're making in like right around that time. That's when you're making T. So if you're skipping out on sleep, you're probably going to have low androgens, and that andropause for guys, like I mentioned, can happen at any age. And then women also need testosterone. So usually you think of female hormones, you think of estrogen first, which is true. And after menopause, low estrogen and osteoporosis. And then you think about maybe progesterone if you're keen on that, but they need a little bit of testosterone too, just like men need a little bit of estrogen. Cause if you don't have enough estrogen as a guy, you can have osteoporosis at a younger age. You can have sexual dysfunction, mood conditions. So a lot of these things are nuanced that, you know, most likely, unless you see as a female, like an OBGYN who is also doing functional medicine or anti-aging hormone replacement therapy medicine, they're probably not going to go into this nuance with you. They're probably not going to do urine and blood testing, which I think every male and female, if they can afford it, should get both. Like a Dutch test, which is a lot cheaper if you order it through a doctor like me, but you can pay more if you have the money and just order it yourself. It's like reading Greek if you don't know how to interpret that test. So you're going to have to hire someone to interpret it for you. Even doctors have to get training to learn how to interpret it. That's why I say that, not to demean anybody's intelligence, but the blood tests are also crucial because then you have, okay, the blood, this is what you're finding at that time of day when you test it in your blood. And then this is the urine metabolite. So this is probably what the receptors are utilizing. You know, this is the bioavailable hormones that your hormone receptors are utilizing. And I hope in the future in science, we'll have tests that are specific to androgen, estrogen, and progesterone receptors. Right now, the tests that we have for that, as far as I know, are for like estrogen and progesterone positive breast cancers in oncology, but we don't have tests for like the average guy to say like, okay, your testosterone is 800 total. It's 15 or 25 or 30, which is awesome. Free testosterone, but your androgen receptors are like only at 20% capacity. So that's why you actually feel like crap. And let's see what we can do to work on that. or looking at dehydrotestosterone, which has been demonized for men because they thought that it caused prostate cancer, but actually having optimal levels of dehydrotestosterone optimizes your chances of having a healthy prostate, healthy brain, healthy heart, because your androgen receptors love DHT, dehydrotestosterone. And you're going to have lower libido if you don't have enough. You're going to have increased chance of prostate diseases, so enlarged prostate or prostate cancer. And it's actually chronic inflammation, insulin resistance, and elevated toxic estrogen metabolites that you can look for that cause prostate cancer, not dehydrotestosterone. You do need to have testosterone, and dehydrotestosterone doesn't convert to estrogen like total testosterone does. So there's a lot, basically, before I like keep going on my spiel, I just want to say that there's a lot, if you're listening to this and you're like, whoa, like we just went into outer space.
Yeah. It's overwhelming sometimes.
Yeah. Dr. Sam just took off and like, he's, you know, 300,000 miles out there going to Pluto without me talking about hormones and I don't get it. Just schedule a free consult with me and we can see like if you actually need to get your hormones optimized, or just go to my website, apollohealthclinic.com, and you can check out some free resources there. You can download for free. I also have my own podcast with 61 published episodes. So you can just look at one that looks like it calls to you and you want to learn more about it. You can check those out.